In these three laser scribe processes, they're only very roughly aligned to each other, so there's no lithographic patterning or anything going on over here. Only way these laser scribes are aligned is optical alignment. And that essentially, you know, requires you to leave quite a bit of spacing between each of these laser scribes. So essentially, if I think about this region, which is in between these three laser scribe, that essentially is the width of this region is you know, typically hundreds of micron in usual cells. So, and also this region is not contributing to any solar energy conversion, or this is not essentially being part of a cell. So this constitute what is the dead region, which is called as often the dead region in my cell, and its width is denoted by, I'm denoting over here by this symbol WD over here. So if you're a solar cell manufacturer, you essentially, you know, want to minimize the fraction of this dead region. So let's say this is my dead region and this is my actual cell. So I want to minimize the fraction of this width of the dead region versus the width of my cell. So essentially I want to minimize this fraction, which is WD by W. So WD would be, you know, fixed by how precisely I can align these different scribes. So essentially a way to reduce this fraction would be to essentially maximize my cell width. So if I can make each of these cells very wide, the contribution due to this or the no contribution due to this dead region, it becomes insignificant. But this poses another problem, and the problem with the large width of these thin film cells is that of I square R drop, or the resistive drop across these TCO materials. And let me explain that, what does mean. So essentially these cells are interconnected using these TCO materials. So the current would essentially be coming into this TCO material from so all the photons which are being absorbed, they would essentially, you know, get collected in this top TCO, and then they will essentially, you know, go and go again, and there's a series connection between this and the next cells. But even this, within this one cell, since this TCO material is placed on the top and it's series connected to the other cell using just this small trench over here, the current, as you can see, is not uniform throughout this island of the top TCO. So essentially this, all the photons which are absorbed over here, they'll come in and constitute the current over here. But then in this region, these photons will again come in over here and contribute to the current. And similarly, you can see that the current inside this top TCO, it's growing, or, you know, it's increasing as I'm moving from left to the right. So if I think of my current and I plot it as a function of this direction x, so my ix, or my current inside this TCO2, it's increasing linearly as a function of x. So if I think of this in terms of a current density, so let's you know, denote it what this current would be. So I can think of this in terms of current density, and let's say I'm operating at the maximum power point. Then the current as a function of x, it would essentially increase linearly as x. And this has to be multiplied by the total length of this cell. So now this is my current through this TCO region as a function of x. So what is the power loss due to this current? Is essentially the I square R loss in the cell. And let me write down over here. So the power loss, which is essentially associated with this drop, would be I square multiplied by the resistance. So I can express that in terms of the sheet resistance. And I need to now integrate it over this x. So my x will now vary from 0 to again W, which is the width of the cell. So I can substitute for this formula for Ix from over here into this relationship. So I see my current, it has a square. So my current has a linear relationship with x. So my I square will have a square relationship with x. And when I integrate it over, I'll get essentially a cube relationship in terms of my width. So the total power loss would be essentially this power, which is lost over here. When I integrate it, it would have essentially a 1/3 term, and then a cubic dependence on the width of the cell. And then these other terms, which is L square term from here, which will divide by, so I will leave a L term over here. And then I'll have a sheet resistance term and a square of this maximum power current density. So this is my power, which is essentially lost in due to this I square R loss. So what is the fraction of power loss? So essentially the fraction of the power lost is essentially this by the power produced, and the power produced is power produced. I can express this in terms of my maximum power density multiplied by essentially my voltage at which the maximum power is produced. So if I do that, essentially I'll get, and you know, I'll multiply it by the total area of the cell. So if I do that, the fraction of the power loss due to this I square R drop, this fraction, it comes out to be, you know, 1/3 of my 1/3, and then I have this current term over here, the voltage term over here, and a square term from, you know, this cube term divided by this W leaves the square terms in terms of the width, and then this sheet resistance, which comes into play from over here. So now essentially, you know, I have this fraction, which is lost due to this dead region, and then I have this fraction, which is lost due to this I square R loss. So I want to minimize the overall loss of the power. So essentially the total power loss is this power loss, which happens due to the dead region, and this second term over here, which happens due to this I square R loss over here. And you can clearly see that they have different dependences on the width of the cell. So this first term is minimized when you have a large width. So if W is large, this first term is minimized. But the second term, which is due to the I square R loss, is minimized when you have a small width. So essentially, when you have a small width, you'll have less current crowding, you'll have less I square R drop, and that would minimize this second term.